Déjalo ir.
Lost your key, ma'am?
No, not me key. Me pan. It always sat there empty, this hurt. That is, till the night afore the battle. A man arrived, walked right in like 'twere his own. He was standing at my window, peering at the goings on. He must have been. 'Cause next I knew, there he was, coming my way. So, I grabbed me pan, for protection, see? But he just asks all polite, Gran, got any birch bark by chance? Lilac berries or even a few coals? Nay, says I, and you must be right daft to pester folk at night with such foolery. Staring at me pan like a magpie at a copper. Lend it to me, Gran. I'll give it back come morn. Baffled for what's he doing, frying in the dark. But I've got a soft heart, so I gave it to him.
Fascinating story. Any chance you're nearing the end?
Before dawn, another rode up to the hut. Come on, only the first fella left. Locked the door, hopped on his horse, and that were all I saw of him, and me pan. 'Twere old, black with soot, not worth much, I suppose, but I've no other. Will you help me, dearie? Bring an old widower pan? I could never break down that door myself. And in truth, I'm afeard to go in any room. Such a stench wafting out. Methinks the other fellow. Well, that he's lying there.
Never taken on a pan contract. Fine, I'll go in, look around. You should wait here, just in case. A corpse. Explains the stench. His throat. He was garroted. And some old scars. Kind a soldier might have. His
What's
throat.
That,
he was garroted.
Nothing. Nothing.
And some
but
old
when
scars.
I And I a say soldier I'm going for me.
Documents, almost entirely burnt. A few pieces still legible.
Found the pan, have you?
Ah, the priceless frying pan. Scrubbed clean. Looks like the mystery man didn't need the pan so much as the soot off it to make ink, write letters.
Found the pan, have you?
Here, your frying pan.
Mine? But mine were black with soot. And I could see myself in this one if I wanted. But them years are past.
It was the soot the man needed. He scraped it off to make ink. Must have had an urgent letter to write. Urgently burned some other documents, too.
And the other fellow?
Dead. Round up a few boys and bury him outside the village. Deep, so the necrophages don't dig him up. And take my advice. Don't mention this to the Nilfgaardians.
Hang about! You've earned a token of thanks. Here, sonny, for the road. Fry up a nice white fish for
Ooh!
Whoa there, Roach! Come on, Roach! Come on now.
Come on.
red and northern.
Nordling?
Killing Ted at the game. Ed, Avon, A. Alba.
Military camp. No locals allowed without the express consent of the garrison commander.
I look like a local to you?
You look like trouble.
Dead wrong. I make trouble go away. I'm a witcher.
A witcher?
Captain Peter Sugwin Levy is in the tower. Turn right, past the gate.
Guessing your captain's got work for me.
This is the army, Nordling. There is no guessing.
To the tower. Go.
You'll not get food, not for me.
Nordling? Nordling?
Yes?
We must requisition a share of your harvest.
Aye, Your Excellency.
I know there is little left in your granaries. But soldiers are men too, and so they must eat, correct?
Looking for trouble? Aye, Your Excellency.
Password.
Don't know any.
So, out for a little walkie, eh? Counting the Emperor's swords to lull you to sleep? Well, in the army, we've a place for nosy ramblers. The scaffold.
And thick-skulled quartermasters? They got a place.
You're clearly skilled at banter. And haggling? You got a knack for that as well?
Morale holding up around here? You boys think you can win this thing?
Ah, a spy after all. Or one to stir trouble.
Neither. Just curious.
Right. Well, tell anyone who cares we will win this war, because Radovid is mad, as everyone knows, and we've an extraordinarily well-drilled and well-supplied army. Incidentally, did you wish to buy something?
I'd like you to craft something for me.
Thank you.
So long.
How much grain will your village give?
Whatever you say, Your Excellency.
Look at my hands. Look. See the calluses? These are not the hands of an Excellency, but of a farmer. So we speak peasant to peasant. How much can you give?
40 bushels. There'd be more, sir, but our lads, the Temerians, that is, took from us earlier and...
You will give 30, and that will do. Let us settle on it. And I wish to see the transport soon.
Oh, thank you, sir. Thank you kindly.
I summoned only the Elderman and the smith, Willis. But it is said he is a dwarf. You are too tall to be him.
Very perceptive of you. Geralt of Rivia, Witcher.
Vatgern. This explains why I did not hear your footsteps. What do you seek here?
Yennefer of Vengerberg. Where was she headed?
That is a military secret.
Haven't thrown me out yet. Haven't called the guards. So go ahead. What's your price?
There is a griffin in the area. Slay it. And then I shall see what I can do.
Why do you care about this griffin?
Because I care about people. The beast has killed 10 already, including a few of my men. To hunt it, I would need to mobilize the entire garrison, comb the woods, organize a battu. Simply impossible.
Too big a hassle?
No. Too high a risk. I cannot disperse my forces. Temeria's army we have crushed, but its common folk remain. Ready to answer a call to arms. So, as to this griffin, I can sit on my hands or hire a professional.
It's a deal. Some questions before I start. Know where the griffin has its lair?
It kept to the Vulpine Woods at first. I sent a patrol there, 5 young men. A hunter found them 2 days on. They only recognized them because they wore our plate. Since then, the griffin has grown bold. Attacks in villages, fields, on the main road.
Meaning it's abandoned its lair. Gonna have to set a trap.
I judge from your tone, this will not be easy. What do you require?
I'll need bait, a specific herb, buckthorn. Scent should lure the griffin from 10 miles off.
Buckthorn? I do not know this. But I am not yet fluent in the common tongue.
Mm-hmm. Probably mastered the basics, though. Hands up. Kill them.
No. First came idioms. Don't play with fire, for example. Go to Tomira, an herbalist. She lives near the crossroads. She will aid you.
Need more information about this griffin. Its sex. Why it's abandoned its lair.
Shall I bring you witnesses?
They won't say anything I don't already know. I need to go where your men died. Look around. What's the name of the hunter who found them?
Mislav. He has a hut south of the village, very near the wood. Helpful fellow. A little strange, though.
Tamira and Mislav. Thanks.
Es sun yakten.
Heard of the Vryhead Brigade?
Your kind.
Make way.
Could he deliver us from evil?
Thank you. Where'd you come from?
If I ever have a son, I'll name him Geralt.
Greetings.
Greetings.
Wouldn't mind a look at your stock. Farewell.
Where'd you come from?
Have you been? A good tea?
Greetings.
Bad time.
Not at all. Hand me the beggar tickets, the red bloom. Well, well, one versed in herbs.
Probably saying too much, but I know a bit. For instance, that beggar tick's poisonous.
In large doses, small ones soothe pain and bring forth pleasant dreams. Which is all I can hope to do for her.
Griffin, do that to her.
Delina. Yes. Attacked her at night. She was walking in the woods.
At night? Through the woods? In wartime?
Meeting a boy. The young, you know, do foolish things for love. Wounds are healing, but she will die. Blood's pooling in her skull. Nothing my Bruce can do to help.
Could try to help her with one of my potions. Swallow can heal internal hemorrhages.
But?
Witcher's potions aren't for humans.
She'll die as it is.
Yes. A peaceful death soothed by your concoctions. If I give her Swallow and something goes wrong, the whole village will hear her screams.
I understand. Do as you will.
Looking for buckthorn. Know if it grows anywhere around here?
Hmm. Bottom of the river, where the channel's widest. But you do know that once out of the water...
It'll stink worse than a week-old carcass. Counting on it. I'm hunting the griffin. Need the buckthorn for bait.
I was thinking. A few years ago, we had trouble. Drowners under the bridge. The whole village had to pitch in for a witcher. Who now can afford the bounty on a griffin's head?
Captain Peter Sars, something.
Ah, good to know the Black One's looking out for our welfare.
Doubt Emperor Amir cares about you, but this captain just might. Seems like a decent man.
There are no decent men in the army. There are only orders.
Not from here, are you? A lot of bitterness in you. Too much for someone who's spent her life in a hut in the middle of nowhere.
True. And you're in a hurry. Elsewise you'd not use bait, just wait for the griffin to attack again.
Believe we could have an interesting conversation.
Maybe next time. Yes?
Tell me something about yourself. What's your story?
A sad one. Do you know the Temple of Melitele in Alanda?
Do I know it? Can't remember how many times I've been there, how many times Mother Nenica stitched me up.
We must have missed each other. I started to become a healer under Mother Nenica. I was but 18 when they took me in. An age at which teachings interest one far less than love. There was a boy, Goslath. He'd bare his chest to work. The novices couldn't keep their eyes off him, tripped over their own feet, dropped things. I left the temple for him. We passed a lovely summer together, and then he left. Nenike refused to take me back. My parents uttered not a word. Gave me a travel cloak and a small coin pouch. I struggled long to find a place where I'd feel safe, needed. Until I finally arrived here. End of story.
Farewell.
Giddy up.
Anyone home? Must be out hunting. Trail's fresh. Mislav just left home. You, Ms. Love?
Shh! Hear that?
Wolves? No, wild dogs.
Yes, more dangerous than wolves.
Dogs more dangerous than wolves? Don't think so.
It's the truth. Know why?
No, but I guess you're about to tell me.
Wolves hunt to fill their bellies. Wild dogs kill for sport.
Just like humans.
Aye. They've learned much from us. Why not cruelty too?
I'm hunting bigger game. The Nilfgaardians the Griffin killed. Where'd you find them?
Ah, I see. You a Witcher. That monster slayer they's talking about in the village.
Mm-hmm.
I'll show you, sure. But, I gotta kill those mutts before they hurt someone. Will you help? That is, if you don't mind blunting your silver blades on them.
Sure. Griffin's not going anywhere.
No. Dogs might, though. So step careful now. Come on.
These dogs been a problem for a while now?
Since the war started. Soldier on the march, he'll stop to rape a woman, strangle her, kill her man for a chuckle, even butcher a cow. But a dog, a kick in passing, no more. So these stray mutts form packs. They're gaunt, guts stuck to their spines, covered in scabies. But they just won't die, because they're clever. More so than foxes. And they hate men something fierce. Too late. Attacked another one. Dieter.
You know him?
We served at the Lord's Manor together, where the Black Army's encamped now. He was a stable hand, I was the Lord's Hunter. But that was before... well, a long time ago.
Before what?
Before they drove me from the village.
What did you do?
Nothing. I'm a freak. Sorry. I'd rather not talk about it.
I'm a freak too.
Aye, but of another kind.
If it's lycanthropy, I can help.
What?
Lycanthropy. Werewolves. Handled a few cases in the past. It's usually a simple curse that...
The Lord's son, Florian, and I... we loved each other. Dieter walked in on us in the stables. They drove me away. Florian hanged himself. Lord started drinking, and the estate fell into ruin. That's the long and short of it.
I'm sorry.
Ancient history now. I was to show you where I found the Nilfgaardians. Come.
Griffin, know anything about it?
Not my kind of game.
You're his kind, though. Survival instincts alone ought to make you care.
I walk silent through the woods. No griffin can hear me nor spy me.
Thank you.
was here. One lay there, by the stump, headless. The other hung from a branch, guts splayed, stretching down to... Watch out for yourself now.
I'll be fine. Not the first griffin I've dealt with. Not likely to be the last, either.
Hope you're right. Good hunting now.
Guardians were celebrating. Griffin interrupted them. Ground's black, saturated with blood. Are older and deeper, heavily armored. Elf guardians, probably.
Come on.
Griffin's nest. What remains of it, at least. Corpse is a couple of weeks old. Still alive when the griffin brought him here. Took a long time dying. Bones. Horse, dog, human. A few months' worth. Have already hatched. Been dead at least a week. Either griffin must be a male. Deep cuts over the whole body. Not a drop of blood on the beak or claws. Didn't defend herself. Crept up on her while she slept. Beak tips worn. Gray hairs in the coat. 10, 12 years old. Griffins pair off for life when young. Male must be about the same age. Thick shaft, dense barbs. A royal griffin. Explains why the male I ran into was so aggressive. Hunted the Nilfgaardians down here in the forest first, then started prowling the area. This